In this video, you'll see how the Sigma 24-105's autofocus performs tracking fast-moving subjects. I'll be running two tests, one for photo and one for video. So recently we bought the Sigma 24-105 F4 Art. Even though I haven't had it for a long time, my first impressions is that it's amazing. The first time I used it was when I took it down to the dog park to test if it could track all the moving dogs. And looking at these images on screen, it did a pretty darn good job. In most of the photos, it seemed to have nailed the focus pretty well, and it rarely missed. But after that, I wanted to put the autofocus to test to see how it really performed. So we took our beautiful, stylish dog, Valley, to the park and threw the frisbee for her. And then with the 24-105, I would track her as she ran back. In terms of photos, the autofocus was absolutely amazing. Even in some of the sequences and photos, you could see it got 100% of the photos in focus. Now, on the other hand, in terms of videos, it also performed pretty well. As I haven't had it for a long time, I didn't really know how it was going to perform. As you can see, it did at least a pretty good job, or at least better than what I expected. Some clips, Valley was in focus the whole time, others not at all. And for some, I also accidentally flicked the ISO to ISO 12,800. Great job, me. To summarize, I think the Sigma 24-105's autofocus is absolutely amazing for its price tag. It performs really well both in video and photo. If you haven't already got a 24-105, consider Sigma's. In my opinion, the Sigma Art Series lenses are just so sharp and have really good autofocus too. Thanks for watching. Please do consider giving a like, comment, and even subscribing. And also, soon I'm going to be doing a comparison between the Sigma 24-105 and the Sony 24-105, so stick around for that.